Here's what we all can learn about writing from one of the very best writers at work today, Stephen King. We recently published Stephen King's number one bestseller, Billy Summers, which I loved. People magazine described Billy Summers as a noirish, unputdownable thriller that's also King's best book about his own craft since On Writing. And that review propelled me to read On Writing, to learn Stephen King's best writing tips, and also to see how closely our author followed his own advice writing Billy Summers. Observation number one, good story ideas seem to come quite literally from nowhere, sailing at you right out of the empty sky. He tells the story behind the inspiration for his first published novel, Carrie. He'd always been interested in telekinesis, and then he found himself thinking about adolescent cruelty, and pow, the two ideas came together. He was writing it in the laundry room of his trailer, but he didn't like the early pages and he threw them out. Fortunately, his wife Tabitha fished the pages out of the garbage can, read them, and urged him to stick with it. Which brings us to rule number one. Stopping a piece of work just because it's hard, either emotionally or imaginatively, is a bad idea. Rule two, story is honorable and trustworthy. Plot is shifty. He explains, I distrust plot for two reasons. First, because our lives are largely plotless, even when you add in all our reasonable precautions and careful planning. And second, because I believe plotting and the spontaneity of real creation aren't compatible. Stephen King certainly follows this rule in Billy Summers, the story of a principled hitman on his last job. When things go wrong, Billy is suddenly on the run, and his decisions about how to react feel spontaneous to the moment. Rule three, description begins in the writer's imagination, but should finish in the reader's. For me, good description usually consists of a few well-chosen details that will stand for everything else. In Billy Summers, one of the killers has a man bun. An assailant wears a Melania Trump mask, and Billy eats SpaghettiOs when he's hiding out in the basement. All of these details are specific and instantly memorable. Rule four, on building characters. The job boils down to two things, paying attention to how the real people around you behave and telling the truth about what you see. Billy Summers was real to me, which is quite an accomplishment because I don't know any hitmen, and I never really thought I'd be able to relate to one. But Billy Summers is brainy and resourceful. He reads Zola, he's writing his own book, and he's a master of disguise. But most amazingly, I liked Billy. Even though he's a killer, he has integrity. He has a reason for the pain he feels and the pain he's caused. In On Writing, Stephen King observes, I grew up as part of America's lower middle class, and they're the people I can write about with the most honesty and knowledge. There's nothing elitist about Stephen King's fiction, and he's got discipline and a work ethic. He says he writes every morning, usually about 2,000 words or 10 pages a day, and he's open to ideas whenever they occur to him, in the shower, on his daily walks, and while he's driving. He observes, I have written because it fulfilled me. Maybe it paid off the mortgage on the house and got the kids through college, but those things were on the side. I did it for the buzz. I did it for the pure joy of the thing. And if you can do it for the joy, you can do it forever. Here's hoping that Stephen King does it forever. And that is the word according to Carr.